Hi, this is Bob from Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff, and if you're looking for an online Toughbook community that gives tips, tricks, and support, hit the subscribe and bell button for notifications of all our upcoming videos. Today, I'll be answering a few of your questions on the CF-53, so stay tuned. Hi, thanks for watching. Today, I'm just going to do some quick Q&A on our Panasonic Toughbook CF-53 videos. I'll dive right in. My first question is from Randy S. Hi, Bob. I was just wondering if I need to recalibrate the battery after installing a new battery. How important is it to recalibrate the battery, and is this something you need to do? Hey, and by the way, Bob, thank you for all your videos. Well, Randy, you're very welcome. And let me just touch base a little bit on the Panasonic Toughbook CF-53 battery when you put a new one in. Yes, Panasonic has a utility you can download off their website that is a battery recalibration tool. Now, the way I look at it is we don't normally do it with new batteries unless there's an issue. We find an issue with the battery, we'll use the recalibration tool to check it out. But in general, you don't necessarily need to recalibrate or to calibrate your battery as a brand new battery. Unless you have a problem. So that's my answer, Randy. I hope that helps. Our next question comes from Ignat Polkov. Thanks for the walkthrough. I just plan to buy this laptop even if I really don't need so much durability, but because I like durable, portable electronics. What about some suggestions about RAM modules or SSD drives that will be best for this PC? Also, can you tell me about the revisions for this laptop? Really good question. The memory that you would use is PC3L12800. That's some DDR3. It comes in 8 gig sticks, so you can max out your CF-53 memory to 16 gigs. As far as SSDs are concerned, our favorite SSD is the Samsung brand. It seems to be the most reliable. They're a little harder to get a hold of because I think everybody likes them. But that's what I would suggest. So as far as revisions are concerned, Panasonic Toughbooks come in different generations. So they call them MKs, MK1, MK2, MK3, MK4. The CF-53 was MK1 through MK4. And that just basically tells you how old they are. So the MK1 would be the first model of the CF-53 that came out, with the MK4 being the newest one that you can buy at, because it's discontinued, that would be the newest one you could buy. The differences in them are typically just the processor. So as Intel came out with new revisions to the CPU, Panasonic would buy them and install them in the system board so that you would get a slightly different version of the processor. There are other minor details they changed, like for example in MK4 they moved from going from the large Gobi 5000 card to the mini 5000 card, the Gobi 5000 card. So there's a slightly different part that you need if you buy the MK4. There's also different wireless cards that they installed in the newer units. But that was because as they made these, technology became better and they utilized that. So that's the difference in the different versions of the generations. Well, I hope that answered your question. So the next question comes from Paul D. I've been using the CF series in the field for over 8 years now. Yep, I love the CF-53. Also, one thing I can't find, the part number for the built-in optional webcam. Can you help with that, Bob? Well, Paul, I'm going to do the best I can. Here's a couple of things that you need to know, is that the CF-53 webcam was only available and can only be installed in CF-53s with the touch screen. And that's because the webcam plugs into the touch screen board. That's how they integrated into the system. The downside is I don't know the part number. You can purchase the webcam from Panasonic. However, you will need the model that originally came with the webcam in order for them to sell it to. So you'll need the serial number of the unit that actually has a webcam so that you can claim you're just replacing it. Panasonic will not let you retrofit items that weren't originally sold with the model that you're trying to upgrade. I know, I don't like it either, but it is a reality that they forced us into. I hope that helps you. Our next question comes from John K. John asks, the most frustrating thing about the CF-53 is finding the proper drivers for Windows 7. The most frustrating thing is finding drivers, period, for Panasonic Toughbooks. But I will tell you, the drivers for Windows 7 on the CF-53 are some of the easiest ones to find. I'm gonna leave the link down in the description that will take you right to the website that we download all of our drivers from. Unless you know the specific driver you're looking for, I can't really give you a direct link, but definitely when you go to this one, it is the Japanese support site. That's the one we like to use because it's so much more straightforward, and you'll be able to easily find any drivers for Windows 7 on your CF-53. So I hope that helps. Well, that's all I got for you today. I hope you enjoyed it. Hey, leave your questions down in the comments. I really want to answer more questions. I want to know what you guys need to know so I can help you out. Other than that, I'll see you next week.